Hello and welcome to episode 8 in the Power On series. Last episode we looked at the EPROM verifier. This episode we're going to be looking at the merits of the ATM and the BFL. So Millie, what can you tell me about some of the differences and the merits of them?
Sure, so as you mentioned in the last episode, we looked at the EPROM verifier. Now that specific instrument only comes with the BFL, the Board Fault Locator. So with the EPROM verifier, what we can do is simply read the data from an EPROM and then save that data, which we can then use at a later stage to compare against another PCB, another EPROM, to verify that that EPROM is correct, working as it should be, and the data within it is not faulty or corrupt or anything along the lines of that. We also have the digital IC tester live comparison. What this allows us to do is, if we have two PCBs side by side, we can simply do a quick live comparison of any two ICs that you may want to test to quickly identify a fault and then move on into testing other components, let's say. We also have the advanced graphical test generator, which is available between both modules. But what I find is the BFL, the board fault locator, is particularly good at testing digital ICs in circuit, and you know, with the ATM, more of a board level test. But obviously both modules work hand in hand.
So obviously physically they don't look that different from each other, but I can see that the BFL has a power supply built in.
Yeah, that's a good point, Oliver. So with the BFL itself, it has its own power supply, which is a 5 volts power supply, and obviously because it comes with the module itself, it's very safe and it works in hand with everything else.
So the ATM works with the PPS as well, but you can also use your own external power supply alongside with them. So how many channels are on these modules?
Okay, so we can have up to 256 channels. And as you may have noticed, with the BoardMaster itself, we have 6 modules in total. We recently had a customer requesting a larger case, and in that larger case, we could accommodate up to 10 modules. So depending on what your requirements are, we can accommodate for that. So with the ATM, I would say that that's more useful when it comes to board level tests, as explained in episode 4, where we looked at the two test rigs.
Yes, in episode 4 we looked at the two test rigs. We had a test rig from our military customer, and what we used, we actually used both of these modules to actually check the entire board, and what we used the ATM for was to check the majority of the functionality of the whole PCB assembly. And it went into detail and checked each individual component with the BFL.
Exactly. So we used the advanced board checker, which allowed us to do a complete board level test. But again, like you mentioned, both modules work hand in hand, and they're both really brilliant at testing digital components as well as PCBs.
Yeah.
Whether that's both in or out of circuit as well.
Yeah. So both of them together gives you a broader range of testing those digital components. Thank you, Minnie. So that was our episode on the merits of both the BFL and the ATM. In the next episode, we'll be doing a complete summary of this series. So stay tuned for that.